Hello, welcome to Incognito, the word game for verbal virtuosos. Today's is a first round game, and taking their test drive on our wheels today are Deborah Lewis, originally from Newcastle, now living in London, Graf Kelly, who's from South Norwood in London, Umu Zubairu, who's from Manchester. Deborah, I've been longing to meet you, because one of the perks of my job is I get to learn things that I need to know. I've got a seven-year-old son called Duncan, came to me the other day and said he wants to learn guitar. And I know that, as well as teaching English, you also teach classical guitar. What should he do?
Well, he's a perfect age, age seven. I was six when my father, who's also a classical guitarist, started me off. And a half-size guitar would be a good idea.
So how many times will he have to practice?
Well, every other night for about 10, 15 minutes.
Every other night for 10, 15 minutes?
Yes, that would be
good. I'll suggest that to him, see if he still wants to learn the guitar.
Absolutely.
Deborah, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Glad to see you. Graf.
Hello.
You're an estate agent.
Yes, unfortunately.
People have an impression that estate agents are sometimes dull people. You're not dull at all, are you?
I don't think so.
Tell us about your hobby.
I've just joined a circus class.
A circus skills class. What does that mean, mucking out elephants?
Something like that, yeah. You get to wear a funny hat.
So what do you actually learn?
Juggling, tightrope walking, unicycling.
So how are you getting on so far?
I juggle three balls.
Three balls?
Without a unicycle.
Without a unicycle. So one day you're going to be on a high wire with a unicycle juggling three balls.
Maybe six balls even.
Maybe six, not bad. Welcome to the show, Graf.
Thanks.
Hope you enjoy it. Umu.
Hi.
You can't cook. You're honest enough to say that.
Yeah, it's
Your
true.
Boyfriend can't cook either.
Yeah, that's true.
But you have a fabulous way of choosing who cooks. Tell us about it.
Well, we bet on the outcome of natural occurrences. We'll look out the window and someone will bet on how many birds will leave the lawn or land on the lawn. You know, we'll bet on when the next advert will come on a television programme, anything.
So whoever loses cooks?
Yes.
So who's the best better and who's the worst cook?
Well, we're both bad as each other, but I'm the best better.
So he cooks more times than you?
He certainly does.
Well done. Welcome to the show. Ladies and gentlemen, our contestant. Okay, as nobody's played the game before, let me remind everybody of the rules. The answers we're looking for are staring you in the face because, arranged around the outside of a wheel, there's a loop of 30 letters, and those letters spell out a never-ending circle of words, and amongst those words are the answers we're looking for. We have three different kinds of wheels, and we always start with a quiz wheel. Now, these are six general knowledge questions. You get to pick which question you want to answer. As soon as I start asking the question, the wheel starts to turn. It doesn't stop until you give me an answer, or you run out of 3 seconds thinking time. If you give me a right answer, you get 10 points. If you happen to give me a wrong answer or no answer, it doesn't matter, because the wheel's not finished till I've asked each question 3 times, or I've got 6 correct answers. Deborah gets to start. You pick a question, Deborah.
Number 3, please.
Number 3. Which American actor played Butch in Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid?
Paul Newman.
He did. You get 10 points. Graf.
Number 2, please.
Number 2. In 1945, who ordered the atomic bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki? Umu.
Number 6, please.
Number 6. What was the title of Ken Russell's 1986 mock horror film starring Gabriel Byrne and Natasha Richardson? Back to you, Deborah.
Question 2, please.
Question 2. In 1945, who ordered the atomic bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki?
Truman.
It was Harry S. Truman. Another 10 points to you. Graf.
Number 5, please.
Number 5. Regarded by the ancient Chinese as sacred, which aromatic plant is used in the distilling of pastis? Umu.
Number 1, please.
Number 1. In 1980, who won the Academy Award for Best Director with the film Ordinary People? We'll come back to it. Deborah.
Question 1, please.
Question 1. In 1980, who won the Academy Award for Best Director with the film Ordinary People?
Was it Robert Redford?
It was Robert Redford again. Another 10 points. You've got a hang of this game. Graf.
4, please.
4. Who has played Vera Duckworth in Coronation Street since 1976?
Dawn.
Dawn, Elizabeth Dawn. You're on the scoreboard. Time for Umu to have a go.
Number 5, please.
Number 5. Regarded by the ancient Chinese as sacred, which aromatic plant is used in the distilling of pastis? Deborah.
Question 5, please.
Do you think you've got the answer? Regarded by the ancient Chinese as sacred, which aromatic plant is used in the distilling of pastis?
Is it anise?
It is.
10 points for you again.
Which leaves Graf with question six. What was the title of Ken Russell's 1986 mock horror film starring Gabriel Byrne and Natasha Richardson?
Gothic.
It was Gothic. You get 10 points. Well done. OK, we've had a quiz wheel, and as ever, it's followed by a puzzle wheel. Let me remind you, these are six crossword puzzle clues. Some are cryptic, some are clever, some just maybe funny. You never know your luck. This time, you get 5 seconds thinking time. We'll start with Graf. Choose a clue.
Two, please.
Two. They go around with a group, but they're not groupies. Umu.
Number two, please.
Number two. They go around with a group, but they're not groupies.
Entourage.
Correct. 10 points. Deborah.
Clue three, please.
Clue three. I'm inclined to agree it's a bit steep. Graf.
Clue three, please.
I'm inclined to agree it's a bit steep.
Gradient.
Gradient's right up to 10 points.
Number four, please.
Number four. Male sunbathers use them to cover their little peccadilloes. Oh dear, it stays on the wheel.
Clue four, please.
Clue four. Male sunbathers use them to cover their little peccadilloes.
Thong.
Very good, thank you. Very good. Graf, one, five or six?
Six, please.
Six. It's been waxed, so it's good on a roll. Some of them are clever. Umu.
Number one, please.
Number one. If you pick the right flavour, it'll last for weeks. Deborah.
Number five, please.
Number five. He's not a dedicated follower of fashion, he leads it. Graf.
One, please.
One. If you pick the right flavour, it will last for weeks.
Month.
Month's the right answer. Thank you. Umu, five or six?
Number five, please.
Number five. He's not a dedicated follower of fashion. He leads it.
Guru.
Guru. Number 10. Leaves Deborah with clue six. It's been waxed, so it's good on a roll.
Marge?
It's not what we want.
It's not on.
Graf, it's you to save the day. Tricky, this one. It's been waxed, so it's good on a roll.
Run.
Tell him, Deborah.
Edam.
Edam was the answer. Unfortunately, you don't get the 10 points in spite of getting it right. OK, we've had two wheels. Let's have a look at the scores. Umu's on 20 points, Graf's on 40 points, but Deborah's currently leading on 50 points. Well done. Here's the moment you've been waiting for, Deborah. It's your word wheel, and in 30 seconds' time, it'll all be over. All I'm going to ask you to do is say and spell each word that you see on the wheel. Make sure they've got three letters in them. Make sure you avoid abbreviations and proper nouns. But your 30 seconds start as soon as you see the wheel turning.
Red, R-E-D. Decorate, D-E-C-O-R-A-T-E. Rate, R-A-T-E. Ten, T-E-N. Tendon, T-E-N-D-O-N. Set, S-E-T. Tail, T-A-L-E. Legal, L-E-G-A-L. Gal, G-A-L. Push, P-U-S-H. Decor, D-E-C-O-R, rat, R-A-T.
Deborah, 12 words, 51 letters, 51 points. Well played. OK, time for another semantic six-pack. This time it's a quiz wheel. Let me remind everybody, these are six general knowledge questions. This time we'll start with Umu. Pick a question.
Number four, please.
Number four. In 1984, which German rock group had a number one hit in the UK with the single 99 Red Balloons?
Nena.
It was Nena. You didn't see it on the wheel, you just thought of it. You get 10 points anyway. Deborah.
Question three, please.
Question three. According to Greek mythology, which princess gave Theseus a glittering thread which enabled him to escape the labyrinth after he slew the Minotaur?
Ariadne.
Ariadne. Thank you. It was a long clue. I didn't want to read it again. Graf.
Number two, please.
Number two. In geomorphology, what is the name given to a long, narrow coastal inlet caused by the submergence of a river valley? We'll come back to it. Umu.
Number one, please.
Number one. What is the name given to the number one or any other number obtainable by repeatedly adding one to the number one?
Cardinal.
Time up. Deborah.
Question one, please.
Question one. What is the name given to the number one or any other number obtainable by repeatedly adding one to the number one?
Cardinal.
Is not the right answer. Grat.
Number five, please.
Number five. Which organic substance is manufactured by heating coal to temperatures of over 1,000 degrees Celsius?
Oil.
Not the answer we want. Umu.
Number one, please.
Number one. What is the name given to the number one or any other number obtainable by repeatedly adding one to the number one?
Natural.
Natural is the answer we want. You get 10 points there. Deborah, 2, 5, or 6?
Question six, please.
Question six. Which 1966 wildlife drama television series took its name from the Swahili for doctor?
Daktari.
It was Daktari. I never knew what it meant. Now I know. 10 points. Grat.
Five.
Number five. Which organic substance is manufactured by heating coal to temperatures of over 1,000 degrees Celsius? Umu.
Number two, please.
Number two. In geomorphology, what is the name given to a long, narrow coastal inlet caused by the submergence of a river valley? Deborah.
Question five, please.
Question five. Which organic substance is manufactured by heating coal to temperatures of over 1,000 degrees Celsius?
It's not Ural.
It's not Ural. Tar was the answer we were looking for. Long question, simple answer, never mind. Graf, you get a chance one more time at question two. In geomorphology, what is the name given to a long, narrow coastal inlet caused by the submergence of a river valley? Another long question, another short answer. Rhea is what we were looking for. R-I-A. Rhea. Never mind. It's your turn, Graf. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay. Say and spell each word that you see. Make sure they've got at least three letters in them. Avoid proper nouns and abbreviations. 30 seconds start as soon as you see the wheel turn.
Traction, T-R-A-C-T-I-O-N. Able, A-B-L-E, let, L-E-T, the, T-H-E, skate, S-K-A-T, 8, A-T-E, teat, T-E-E-T, total, T-O-T-A-L, lair, L-A-R-E, scar, S-K-A.
Right. 9 words, 37 letters, 37 points. Well played. Now you can actually spell K-A-T as well as C-A-T, and it means a shrub that the Arabs put tea off. So if somebody says your tea tastes like cat, they're not necessarily being insulted. Okay, time for more puzzlers, and this time it's a puzzle wheel. Here we have 6 crossword puzzle clues, remember. You have to try for them to get to the answer. I'm going to start this time with Deborah. Pick a clue.
Number three, please.
Number three. You can rely on him even in that state. Graph.
Number three, please.
Number three, you can rely on him even in that state.
Solid.
Solid. 10 points. Solid 10 points. Umu.
Number six, please.
Number six. Fish for fingers in Japan.
Sushi.
Sushi. 10 points. Deborah.
Number four, please.
Number four. The sum of all the parts and the labour. Graph.
Number two, please.
Number two. In my opinion, it's the head count that counts.
Census.
Census. 10 points. Umu.
Number one, please.
Number one. When he's been on the bottle, he can only just walk.
Baby.
Baby. 4 or 5, Deborah.
Number five, please.
Number five. The Gulf's wide and very, very deep.
Drain.
Not what we wanted. Graph.
Number four, please.
Number four. The sum of all the parts and the labour.
voice.
It's not what we wanted. Umu.
Number four, please.
Number four, the sum of all the parts and the labour.
In voice.
That's right. With all Adam. Deborah.
Number five, please.
Number five, the gulfs wide and very, very deep.
Abyss.
Oh, I'm going to give you it just on the buzzer, but only just. Well done, you get 10 points. Okay, Umu, I know you've looked forward to this all day.
Oh, goodness.
Remember to say and spell each word that you see.
Right.
Remember that each one must have at least three letters in it.
Okay.
Avoid proper nouns and abbreviations, but you've got 30 seconds. They'll start as soon as you see the wheel turning.
Discover, D-I-S-C-O-V-E-R. Chore, T-U-R-E. Fine, F-I-N-E. Year, Y-E-A-R. Lychee, L-Y-C-H-E-E. Land, L-A-N-D. And A-N-D. Cover, C-O-V-E-R. Overture, O-V-E-R-T-U-R-E. Refine, R-E-F-I-N-E. Refinery, R-E-F-I-N-E.
Umu, 9 words correct, 48 letters, 48 points. Well played. OK, everybody's had a chance at their own word wheel. Let's see how the scores add up. We can see that Deborah has 131 points, Graf has 97 points, and Umu has 118 points. So currently, Deborah's in the lead. Well done. You can now take a rest, which I'm sure you're looking forward to, because it's time for you at home to play the game once more. Another chance to win a 14-inch portable colour television. In the last show, I asked the question, which star of Cabin QC and A Year in Provence is married to actress Sheila Hancock? And the answer is John Thor. But today we're playing with a new quiz wheel, and our question is, in the Bible, who was warned that it would rain for 40 days and 40 nights? In the Bible, who was warned that it would rain for 40 days and 40 nights? Well, if you think you've spotted the answer, then call us on 0891 11 4400. The winner will be selected at random from the correct entries. The lines will be open until midnight tonight. Calls will last under a minute and will be charged at the premium rate. Now, everybody who watches this show regularly knows this is where it all changes, because we're going to play on the buzzer, which means I will read the questions in order. You buzz in if you think you've got the answer. If you get it right, you get 10 points. But if you get it wrong, you lose 10 points. If you buzz in and you don't have an answer, you'll lose 10 points. If you buzz in and you gurgle, you'll lose 10 points. So please pay attention. If everybody's ready, I'll call up a quiz wheel. I'll remind you again that these are 6 general knowledge questions. So fingers on the buzzers. Here comes the first question. What is an anemometer used to measure the speed of? Deborah.
Is it wind?
It is wind. You get 10 points. Question 2. Which Jordanian city is known as the Rose Red City, half as old as time? Question 3. The son of Quaker parents who directed Blythe Spirit and Brief Encounter? Question 4. In 1938, which actor became the first?
Gable.
Wrong answer, you lose 10 points. Question 5. Michael Jackson played the scarecrow in the film The Wiz, but who played Dorothy? Umu.
Ross.
It was Diana Ross, you get 10 points. Question 6. Which are the only birds in the world that hunt by their sense of smell? Deborah.
Kiwi.
It is kiwi, you get 10 points. Back to question 2. Which Jordanian city is known as the Rose Red City?
Petra.
Deborah. Petra is the right answer. You get another 10 points. Fingers on the buzzers. Here's question 3. The son of Quaker parents who directed Blythe Spirit and Brief Encounter? Deborah.
Tracy.
It's the wrong answer. You lose 10 points. Here's question 4. In 1938, which actor became the first to win 2 Academy Awards in succession?
Deborah. Spencer Tracy.
It was Tracy. You get your 10 points back. Well done. Everybody ready? Here's question 3 for the final time. The son of Quaker parents who directed Blythe Spirit and Brief Encounter? Deborah.
David Lean.
It was David Lean. Well played. You hesitated, but you got it right. Let's see how the scores have changed. Graf has 87 points, Uma has 128 points, and Deborah has 171 points. So you're opening up a lead. Let's have a puzzle wheel. Let me remind you once again, these are crossword puzzle clues, remember? They're cryptic, they're clever, they're each worth 10 points if you get them right. Fingers on the buzzers, here's the first clue. It causes the rattle before you roll dice. Graph.
Shake.
Shake, you get 10 points. Here's clue two. The perfect suit for relaxing in. Deborah.
Lounge.
Yes, indeed. 10 points. Clue three. Look at it in a different way and it makes things smaller. Deborah again.
Telescope.
Is the right answer. Here's clue four. She's dressed to a T. Deborah again.
Geisha.
Another 10 points. Clue five. Everybody ready? It's how you make a date and raise eyebrows. Graph.
Pencil.
Is the right answer. 10 points. Clue six. The fair one in chips. Almost clean sweep, but we stumped you with six. Here it comes again. The fair one in chips. Graph.
Cop.
Is the right answer. Chips the Cop TV show. Okay, let's see how they've changed. Graph's on 117 points. Who moves on 128 points? Deborah's still in the lead on 201. Time to play another quiz wheel. Fingers on the buzzers. You ready for the first general knowledge question? And it is, what is the name for a mechanical model which provides an accurate working representation of the solar system? Here's question two. Which wingless insect is capable of accelerating? Deborah.
Flea.
Flea to more than 200 gravities. Here's question three. In the children's TV series Bagpuss, what is the name of the woodpecker bookend? Graph.
Smith.
Thank you, but it's not. You lose 10 points. Here's question four. Which American tennis star beat Ilina Stasi in the final to win the 1972 Wimbledon men's singles title? Deborah.
Ash.
Is the wrong answer, you lose 10 points. Here's question five. What is the name of the PE instructor from Springfield College, Massachusetts, who invented the game of basketball in 1891? Come back to it. Here's question six. Star of the Mr. Moto film series, which Hungarian actor played Joel Cairo in the 1941 version of The Maltese Falcon? Here's question one again. What is the name for a mechanical model which provides an accurate working representation of the solar system? Question three. In the children's TV series, Graph.
Yaffle.
Yaffles, right. 10 points to you. Here's question four. Which American tennis star beat Ilina Stasi in the final to win the 1972 Wimbledon's men's singles title? Deborah.
Stan Smith.
Is the right answer. Smith had to be right to one of them, and it's that one. Here's question five. What is the name of the PE instructor from Springfield College, Massachusetts, who invented the game of basketball in 1891? Question six. Star of the Mr. Moto film series, which Hungarian actor played Joel Cairo in the 1941? Well, we know what that means. It's the end of today's game. Let's look at the scores. Graf has 117 points. Umu has 128 points. But today's winner, who kept her lead, is Deborah on 211 points. Congratulations. Graf and Umu, I hope you enjoyed playing the game. We'll send you away with a few goodies to remember us by. Deborah, well played. See you in the next round. We hope we see you next time we play Incognito. Bye-bye.
Than a forward roll.
You tried upside down underwater, you don't know what way you're coming out.
Actually still shaking after that. It was terrifying but absolutely fantastic. This is the National Water Sports Centre in Nottingham, but if anyone wants to try kayaking or canoeing this week, where could they go?
Okay, well, there's loads of places throughout the whole of the country where you can canoe, not only just in country parks such as here, but on small lakes and small rivers, etc.
So probably the best thing to do is to contact the British Canoe Union on this number. Well, that's all for the moment. I leave you with our usual high-speed information buzz, outlining things to do and see in the great outdoors. To access the details, you simply replay your videotape and press the pause button at the relevant moments. And don't forget, do join us at the same time next Wednesday for another week in the country. Cheerio.
In next week's programme, we take a look at one of our most lovable wild animals, the seal. At that time, they'll be giving birth to their young on some of our remotest beaches and islands. And John and Joy Bailey, our fishing experts, will be visiting a river which is almost a shrine to one of Britain's most famous anglers, Isaac Walton. Their quarry, the Lady of the River, or the Grayling.
Talking dogs.
Big dogs, small dogs, good dogs, bad dogs.
It's a nasty dog, but that's what I need.
The British are barking mad.
I love the dogs more than the kids.
Dog lovers, dog catchers. It all adds up to
dog trouble.
Tonight at 9 on BBC Two.
Stay.
Okay. Modern times. The way we live now.
This week on Here and Now, Showtime. But even Hollywood can't tempt Wendy to leave her home in Wales and the job she loves.
They might ask me to win the James Bond film or something like that, I'll tell them no.
Also on Here and Now, A Salutary Tale.
If people want a dog with a tail, why don't they go and buy a Labrador?
Right or wrong, tail docking is still widespread.
Chopping an appendage off an animal's body hurts.
Here and Now with Sue Lawley, tonight at 7:30 on BBC One.
Three more brave souls take a spin to play the game now on BBC One with Peter Smith.
Hello, welcome to Incognito, the word game of Spot the Verbals. We have three previous winners with us today, all vying for a place in a quarter-final. So would you please welcome again. Deborah Lewis, originally from Newcastle, but now living in London. Scott Evans from Manchester. And Brenda Holroyd from Holbrook, Suffolk. We had a lovely chat about guitars last time. And
we
my
did.
Son's doing very well, thank you
I'm
very much.
To hear it.
Now, you're an occasional keep fitter, and I suspect so am I. What do you define that as?
Well, by that I mean that every year before our annual summer holiday, I go 3 to 4 times a week for about 6 to 8 weeks.
And you keep it up?
Not afterwards, no.
I go for about 3 to 4 times a week and then quit. But good to see you again. Scott, you keep fit person?
Not at all, no.
Any sports?
Just an armchair fan, I'm afraid. Just
armchair
follow the world's best football team, Manchester United.
You had to get that in.
I did.
And in Manchester. No active sports at all?
No, I did once win the Yard of Ale competition at university.
The Yard of Ale competition, to you that sport. No wonder you listed socialising to excess as one of the great things you do. Scott, welcome back. Hi. Brenda, now we learnt last time just from your performance that you used to be a journalist. You're also married to a journalist.
Yes.
I'm always intrigued. How did you meet?
We met in a police station, in a charge office. So we were strictly there on business. We were both reporters, junior reporters. He was on the Yorkshire Post, I was on the Band of Telegraph and Argus, and that's where we met.
I see.
All the romantic places.
Well, all I know about journalists, I'll believe you.
Right.
Welcome back, Brenda.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, our contestants. OK, everybody's played the game before. We don't need to explain the rules. Today, the gloves are off and everybody's ready for a place in the quarterfinals. So we'll start with the quiz wheel. I'll remind everybody that these are general knowledge questions. As ever, we'll start with the person on the left, which is Deborah. Let me ask you to pick a question.
Number three, please.
Number three. Which Greek mountain, although dedicated to the Virgin Mary, has officially been off-limits for all women since 1060? Scott.
Number five, please.
Number five. Discovered by Adam Faith, which singer had a number one hit with the Burt Bacharach Hal David song Always Something There to Remind Me? Brenda.
Three, please.
Number three. Which Greek mountain, although dedicated to the Virgin Mary, has officially been off-limits for all women since 1060?
Athos.
It is, Athos. Seems a bit unfair to me, but still. Deborah.
Question five, please.
Question five. Discovered by Adam Faith, which singer had a number one hit with the Burt Bacharach Hal David song Always Something There to Remind Me?
Was it Sandy Shaw?
It was. You get 10 points. Scott.
Try number one.
Number one. Please. Star of Rock Follies and Stay Lucky, which actress is Dennis Waterman's third wife?
Lenska.
Well done. You got it just in time. Rula Lenska, 10 points. Brenda, two, four or six?
Two, please.
Number two. The Mock Turtle and the Jabberwocky appear in the books of which children's author?
Carol.
Lewis Carroll. Deborah, four or six?
Number four, please.
Number four. Jeremy Irons provided the voice to which character in the animated Disney film The Lion King? Scott, same choice for you.
Number six, please.
Number six. In which three-handed card game do players bid for the privilege of attempting any of several contracts? Brenda.
Six, please.
Six. In which three-handed card game do players bid for the privilege of attempting any of several contracts?
No, I don't know.
Deborah.
Four again, please.
Four. Jeremy Irons provided the voice to which character in the animated Disney film The Lion King? Never seen it. Scott.
Try number six.
Number six. In which three-handed card game do players bid for the privilege of attempting any of several contracts? Scat's the answer. I've never even heard of it, let alone played it, but it's a card game. There you go. Which leaves Brenda with four. Here we go. Jeremy Irons provided the voice to which character in the animated Disney film The Lion King?
Shower?
It's not the answer, but it was worth a try. Scar is what we wanted. Scar. Never mind. Well, we know what happens now. We have a puzzle wheel. Here we have six crossword puzzle clues. Cryptic, clever, just downright difficult. You never know. You have to decipher the clue to get to the answer. This time we'll start with Scott. Pick a clue.
Three, please.
Three. Eve was the second, but to herself she was the first.
Woman?
That's not the right answer. Brenda.
Five, please.
Five. One of the few things that smoking will cure. Deborah.
Three, please.
Eve was the second, but to herself she was the first.
Person.
Correct. 1 point. Scott.
Number one, please.
Number one. It could get in the way of you enjoying Christmas. And you said on your details you didn't like Christmas. I think you got that. Brenda.
Two, please.
Two. A stormy patch or just a bit wild?
Rough.
Is the right answer. 10 points. Deborah.
Number six, please.
Number six. You can get blue and green blooms of it. Scott.
Number four, please.
Number four. He makes electrical things happen.
Engineer.
Yes. Electrical engineer makes things happen. Brenda.
Six, please.
Six. You can get blue and green blooms of it.
Algae?
It is. 10 points. Don't need to be so hesitant. One or five, Deborah?
Five, please.
Five. One of the few things that smoking will cure?
Cough. No, sorry.
It's a fascinating answer. I don't know how you get to it.
From rough.
It's the wrong one. Scott?
Number one, please.
Number one. It could get in the way of you enjoying Christmas.
Hamper.
Hamper, well. Brenda, last chance to get it. One of the few things that smoking will cure.
Ash?
Ham is what we want to do. It's two obvious ones, you get it. Well done. OK, we've had two wheels. Let's look at the scores. Deborah's on 20 points, Scott's on 30 points, Brenda's on 40 points. Couldn't be simpler. Deborah, you know what happens now.
I do.
Your turn for word wheel. I'll remind you of the rules. You have to say and spell each word that you see. Make sure they've got at least three letters in them. Avoid proper nouns and abbreviations. You've got 30 seconds. They start as soon as you see the wheel turning.
Fragile, F-R-A-G-I-L-E, letting, L-E-T-T-I-N-G. Rat, R-A-T, tag, T-A-G, gem, G-E-M, stone, S-T-O-N-N, gemstone, G-E-M-S-T-O-N-E, turf, T-U-R-F, fragile, F-R-A-G-I-L-E, ingest, I-N-G-E-S-T, rage, no.
Deborah, 8 words, 41 letters, 41 points. Well played. OK, time for another semantic spin, this time with a quiz wheel. Here we have 6 general knowledge questions. This time we're going to start with Brenda. Pick a question.
5, please.
Question 5. The 1993 film The Remains of the Day, starring Anthony Hopkins and Emma Thompson, was based on the novel by which British author? Deborah.
Question 5, please.
Question 5. The 1993 film The Remains of the Day, starring Anthony Hopkins and Emma Thompson, was based on the novel by which British author?
Ishiku Kashiguro. Kashiguro Ishiguro.
Very good. Second time round, I'll give you Ishiguro. I don't know what the first answer was, but we'll ignore it. Scott.
1, please.
1. In 1994, Tonya Harding was banned for life by the US Figure Skating Association for plotting to break the legs of which of her Olympic rivals?
Kerrigan.
Nancy Kerrigan. 10 points. Brenda.
2, please.
2. What is the name given to a star composed of 2 stars moving around each other under mutual gravitational attraction? Come back to it. Deborah.
Question 2, please.
Question 2. What is the name given to a star composed of 2 stars moving around each other under mutual gravitational attraction?
Is it binary?
It is. You get 10 points. Scott.
Number 6, please.
Number 6. What is the name given to a bar or frame by which 2 draft animals are joined at the heads or necks for working together?
Yoke.
It is. Brenda, 3 or 4?
3, please.
3. Which winner of the Australian Junior Backstroke Championship had a top 10 hit in 1993 with the single Stairway to Heaven?
Harris?
It was Rolf Harris. How many people knew he won the backstroke as
Good
a junior?
Heavens, I didn't.
Which leaves Deborah with question 4. Closely related to the curly-coated Galloway, which breed of cattle is characterised by a black coat and a polled head? Scott, see if you know. Closely related to the curly-coated Galloway, which breed of cattle is characterised by a black coat and polled head? I have faith in you, Brenda. Closely related to the curly-coated Galloway, which breed of cattle is characterised by a black coat and polled head?
Is it Harris?
It isn't. Angus is what we want.
Oh, yes.
Any cattle would have done, and there it is, right in the middle of the wheel. OK, Scott, now's your chance. Time for glory. Say and spell each word that you see. Make sure they've got 3 letters in them. Avoid proper nouns and abbreviations. But here you go, 30 seconds as soon as you see the wheel turning.
Self, S-E-L-F, same, S-A-M-E, egg, E-G-G, plant, P-L-A-N-T, ant, A-N-T, turn, T-E-R-N, eat, E-A-T, ten, T-E-N, name, N-A-M-E, lips, L-I-P-S, lip, L-I-P, elf, E-L-F, plan, P-L-A-N, neat, N-E-A-T.
Scott, 14 words, 51 letters, 51 points. Well played. OK, back to the cryptic chase with a puzzle wheel. Again, let me remind you, these are 6 crossword puzzle clues that you have to decipher to get the answer. We'll start this time with Deborah. Pick a clue.
Number 3, please.
Number 3. He'll see you safely to your car.
Escort.
Spot on. Thank you. Scott.
Number two, please.
Number two. It's how things come out of a bag on their own.
Grow.
Grow bag. 10 points. Brenda.
Five, please.
Five. It gets cut up and mopped down. Deborah.
Number one, please.
He rules by bully boy tactics.
Tyrant.
10 points. Scott, four, five or six?
I'll try six, please.
Six. For the Chippendales, it's just another road show. Brenda.
Six, please.
Six. For the Chippendales, it's just another road show.
Antique.
Thank you. 10 points. Deborah, four or five?
Number four, please.
Four, we've not heard this before. Travelling at this speed, you're bound to escape. Scott.
Number five, please.
Avoiding fool. It gets cut up, mopped down. Brenda.
Four, please.
Travelling at this speed, you're bound to escape.
Velocity.
Escape velocity. 10 points. Deborah, your chance to get five. It gets cut up and mopped down. And it's on kitchen floors all over the place. Lino is what we wanted. Never mind. Brenda, you're the only one that hasn't done a word wheel yet, but now's your chance. Remember, you have to say and spell each word that you see. Make sure they have at least three letters in them. Avoid proper nouns and abbreviations. 30-second start as soon as you see the wheel turning.
Gas, G-A-S. Hold, H-O-L-D. Detail, D-E-T-A-T-I-I-L. Literate, L-I-T-E-R-A-T-E. Rate, R-A-T-E. Tempo, T-E-M-P-O. Temporal, T-E-M-P-O-R-A-L. Togas, T-O-A-G-A. Tail, T-A-I-L, illiterate, I-L-L-I-T-E-R-A-T-E, oral, O-R-A-L, alert.
Brenda, you gave us the word illiterate. That hardly describes your performance, does it? You got 10 words right, 56 letters, 56 points. Well done. OK, everybody's had a chance at a word wheel. Let's look at the scores. Deborah has 101 points, Scott has 111 points, and Brenda has 126 points. There's not a lot between you. Chance for you to have a rest, because once again, it's time for you at home to play the game. Another chance to win a 14-inch portable colour television set. In the last show, I asked the question, what is the name of the rabbit in the Magic Roundabout? And the answer is Dylan. I'm sure lots of you got that. And today's question is, Cassio, Iago and Desdemona are all characters in which Shakespearean tragedy? Cassio, Iago and Desdemona are all characters in which Shakespearean tragedy? Now, if you think you've spotted the answer, then call us on 0891 114400. The winner will be selected at random from the correct entries. The lines will be open until midnight tonight. Calls will last under a minute and will be charged at the premium rate. Good luck to everybody. OK, time for the gloves to come off. There's not a lot separating you in terms of score, and everybody's playing for a place in the quarterfinals. One step closer to a trip around the world. Can't be bad. What we do now, as you already know, is we play on the buzzer. I ask the questions in order. You buzz in if you've got the right answer. If you give me the right answer, 10 points. Wrong answer, hesitation, you lose 10 points. So if everybody's ready, I'll call up a quiz wheel. Fingers on the buzzers. Here's the first general knowledge question. Who created the cult American TV series, The Twilight Zone? Question two. Founded in medieval times to export wool, which English port was granted city status? Deborah.
I was going to say York.
You got it wrong, you lose 10 points. Here's question three. Born in Westmoreland, Jamaica, which late reggae artist recorded... Scott.
Marley.
It wasn't Marley, you lose 10 points. Question four. In Charles Dickens' novel, A Christmas Carol, what was the name of Ebenezer Scrooge's late business partner? Brenda.
Marley.
It was Marley, Jacob Marley. Well done. Here's question five. Star of Cabaret and Logan's Run, who made his stage debut in Franco's... Deborah.
Michael York.
It was Michael York. Franco Zeffirelli's production of Much Ado About Nothing. Question six. Dubbed the King of Crazy in France, who starred opposite Dean Martin in 17 feature films? Deborah again.
Lewis.
It was Jerry Lewis. We go back to question one. Who created the cult American TV series The Twilight Zone? We'll come back to it. Here's question two. Founded in medieval times to export wool, which English... Brenda.
Hull.
Hull. Expect you to get that. Here we have question three. Born in Westmoreland, Jamaica, which late reggae artist recorded Hoot Nanny Hoot with the Wailers? Deborah.
Bob Marley.
It wasn't Bob Marley. You lose 10 points. Here's question one again. Who created the cult American TV series The Twilight Zone?
Lewis.
Brenda. It wasn't Lewis. You lose 10 points. The answer was Serling. Rod Serling. Fingers on the buzzers. Last time of asking question three. Born in Westmoreland, Jamaica, which late reggae artist recorded Hoot Nanny Hoot with the Wailers? And if it wasn't Marley, it had to be Peter Tosh. Never mind. Let's look at the scores. We can see Deborah and Scott are neck and neck on 101, but Brenda's in the lead on 136. Let me have a puzzle wheel, please. Remind you, these are crossword puzzle clues. Here's the first one. Fingers on the buzzers. Same name, just older.
Senior.
Deborah. Senior is exactly what we're looking for. 10 points. Here's the second clue. It's what goat rustlers do. Deborah.
Rob.
There's the wrong answer. You lose 10 points. Clue three. The meaning's here. It's just obscure. Deborah.
Hidden.
Hidden. You got them back. 10 points. Clue four. You can count on them giving a little bit on account. Clue five, it's the same colour under the skin. Clue six, it's green and eats greens. Clue two, it's what goat rustlers do. Everybody saw it, Deborah.
Kidnap.
Kidnap, they certainly do. Here's clue four. You can count on them giving a little... Deborah again.
Bank.
Bank. 10 points. Clue five. It's the same colour under the skin. Clue six. It's green and eats greens. Clue five again. It's the same colour under the skin. Brenda.
Orange.
Orange. Well done. 10 points. Everybody ready? Here's clue six. It's green and eats greens. Ah, you missed it. Aphid is what we wanted. There it is in the middle wheel. Let's look at the scores. Scott's on 101. Deborah's on 131. Brenda's keeping her lead on 146. Time for a quiz wheel. Six general knowledge questions. The first one is as follows. Fingers on the buzzers. Which sea-dwelling creature is the only... Deborah.
Seal.
Seal is the wrong answer. You lose 10 points. Here's question two. Published in 1922, which novel by James Joyce describes the events... Deborah again.
Ulysses.
Ulysses. The events of Bloomsday or the 16th of June 1904. Three. Born to Albanian parents, who founded the Order of the Missionaries of Charity? Question four. Made from pureed fruit, baked in a mould, lined with bread. Deborah.
Charlotte.
It is Charlotte. Which warm dessert was named after George III's wife? Here's question five. Taking his name from his collection of porcelain animals, which British singer won 3 Brit Awards in 1992? Deborah.
Seal.
It is. Another 10 points. You've taken the lead. Here's question six. Which biblical character sold his birthright to his... Scott, you got there.
Saul?
It's the wrong answer. You lose 10 points. Go back to question one. Which sea-dwelling creature is the only mammal apart from primates to use a... Deborah?
Otter.
Otter's the right answer. Tool while foraging was the total question. Here's question three. Born in Albania... Excuse me. Brenda?
Teresa.
It was Mother Teresa, in spite of me getting the question wrong. Here we go with question six. Fingers on the buzzers. Which biblical character sold the birthright to his brother Jacob? Brenda?
Esau.
Esau is the right answer. You get 10 points. Scott, you're on 91 points. Deborah's on 161 points. Brenda's got the lead back on 166. Let's have a puzzle wheel. Six crossword puzzle clues to try and baffle you with. Here's the first one. Sounds like the major source of horsehair. Scott.
Maine.
Correct. 10 points. Clue two. As a writer, he has no chance. Deborah.
Ghost.
Ghost of a chance. 10 points. You've taken the lead. Clue three. It's not behind bars. It's in them. Clue four. It's no secret that he's the middleman. Clue five, it's how a baby gets in your good books. Clue six, it might just be a phase, but you can act upon it. Deborah.
Stage.
Correct, 10 points. Go back to clue three. It's not behind bars, it's in the wall. That's the end of the game. Let's have a look at the scores. Scott's on 101 points. Brenda's on 166 points, but you came steaming through at the end. Deborah's the winner today on 181 points. Congratulations. Scott and Brenda, you got through the first round at least, so you can claim to be a winner on Incognito. We'll send you away with a few more goodies to remember us by. But Deborah, congratulations.
Thank you.
You're through to the quarterfinals. One step closer to another trip around the world. Come and see us on the next episode of Incognito. It's not a bad game, is it? Bye-bye.
There's more Disney at Christmas this afternoon here on BBC One with the comedy sequel to The Love Bug. Herbie rides again at 2 o'clock.
It's time to set the table, chalk the cue, split the pack and polish up the players because Big Break's back. Jim Davidson's the perfect host with food and drink to spare. John Virgo's dressing up again and who's that lady there? We've got Alex Hurricane Higgins and the whirlwind Jimmy White.
Come on, Jimmy.
And Steve Davis for an interesting night. We'll champion Stephen Henry, Dennis Taylor, David Rowe, Terry Griffiths, Tony Knowles and Peter Edmonds on the show. The balls are going bonkers just like Jim and Big JB. There's sports of fun on Channel 1 on the BBC.
Big
sports
Break returns tonight, 8:30, BBC One.
Saturday night on BBC One begins with Homer's New Year resolution.
Oh no! 239 pounds! I'm a whale!
From now on, exercise every morning.
And in due south, Fraser gets in touch with his feminine side.
I don't even know who you are.
Actually, I believe you do.
I'm sorry, I don't.
Ray, it's me.
It's Noel's house party at 5 to 7, followed by the National Lottery with Dale and special guest E17. At 8:05, there's trouble underwater in Casualty. And at 9:15, an accidental meeting causes Linda Gray and Linda Pearl to swap lives.
Murder. I wish I could tell you it hadn't entered my mind.
Mine too, many times.
With Match of the Day at 10:45, this is Saturday night on BBC One.
Who will win that luxury holiday? Find out in Wipeout in 25 minutes. First on BBC One, take a spin with Incognito.
Hello, welcome to Incognito, the game where it pays to wordplay. On the last show, Roger Hemming won a place in the semi-finals. He was playing Sara Harwood and Shadia Saeed, and they're our current highest-scoring runners-up. But we have three people with us today who'd like to change all that. So would you please welcome Emma Grayson from Leeds, Ted Daskovich from Grantham in Lincs, and Deborah Lewis from Newcastle. Hello, Emma.
Hiya.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good to hear it. I'm always intrigued what people do while they're away. What have you been up to since I last saw you?
I realised one of my ambitions.
Which was?
To meet Michael Barrymore.
Wow.
Yeah, wow.
How did that go?
Fantastic, yeah. I went backstage, he was in Blackpool.
Yeah.
And went backstage to meet him afterwards and I got my book signed and I got loads of kisses and he called me gorgeous. So I had to ring my mum at 11 at night and say, oh, Michael Barrymore's called me gorgeous. Which were great because she was already in bed.
Lovely. Well, welcome back, Emma. Good to see you again. Ted, now you're a well-travelled man. I didn't realise you'd been to Singapore, Sri Lanka, Hong Kong, Dubai. What took you there?
Work, basically. I was working in the Middle East about 12, 13 years ago. And the other countries were part of a prize for a tournament, a tennis tournament I won a few years ago.
So you like entering competitions where travel is the prize, do I take it?
Hopefully, yes.
Well, good luck today, Ted. Nice Thanks. To see you again. Deborah, you were very kind, gave me some tips about my son learning the guitar last time we met. But not only are you a classical guitarist, you're a good cook. What kind of things do you cook?
I like cooking Chinese food, Indian food.
Yes. All the difficult ones,
all
then?
All the spicy ones, nice
Any ones. Specialties?
Yes, my speciality is taking convenience food out of its packaging, putting it into my own casserole dishes and passing it off as my own.
I didn't know I was a good cook. Nice to see you, Deborah. Ladies and gentlemen, our contestants. Everybody here has played the game at least twice before, so let's call up a quiz wheel and let me remind you of the rules. Here we have six general knowledge questions. You get to pick the question that you want me to ask. As soon as I start asking the question, the wheel starts to turn. It doesn't stop until you give me an answer, or you run out of 3 seconds thinking time. Right answers get 10 points. Wrong answers don't matter, because the wheel's not finished until I've got six right answers. I've asked each question 3 times. So if everybody's ready to play, I'm going to ask Emma to pick the first question.
Number 2, please.
Number 2. In which celebrity's honour did the city of Detroit devote the 24th of February 1967?
Davis.
It wasn't. Ted?
Number 4, please.
Number 4. Lying on the River Onar in the foothills of the Los Angeles Mountains, which city is famous for its Gothic cathedral?
Franklin.
It isn't. Deborah?
Question 2, please.
Question 2. In which celebrity's honour did the city of Detroit devote the 24th of February 1967?
Was it Franklin?
It was, Aretha Franklin. Emma?
Number 1, please.
Number 1. Which Berlin-born golfer, who, like his father, played in the Ryder Cup team, won the Spanish Open in 3 consecutive years?
Langer.
It wasn't. Ted?
Number 5, please.
Number 5. Which Austrian-born film director produced the masterpiece M, A Portrait of a Child Killer, starring Peter Lorre?
Davis.
It wasn't. Deborah?
Question 3, please.
Question 3. In the television programme Alfie Desain Pet, who played Birmingham electrician Barry Taylor? Emma?
Number 6, please.
Number 6. Who stuffed French fries up Michael Palin's nose in the film A Fish Called Wanda?
Spall.
It wasn't. Ted?
Number 5, please.
Number 5. Which Austrian-born film director produced the masterpiece M, A Portrait of a Child Killer, starring Peter Lorre?
Langer.
It wasn't Langer. Deborah?
Question 6, please.
Question 6. Who stuffed French fries up Michael Palin's nose in the film A Fish Called Wanda?
Kevin Kline.
It was Kevin Kline. You get 10 points for it. Emma?
Number 3, please.
Number 3. In the television programme Alfie Desain Pet, who played Birmingham electrician Barry Taylor?
Was that Spall?
It was Spall. Well done. Ted?
Number 5, please.
Number 5. Which Austrian-born film director produced the masterpiece M, A Portrait of a Child Killer, starring Peter Lorre?
Lang.
It was Fritz Lang. Everybody's on the board. Deborah, 1 or 4?
4, please.
4. Lying on the River Onar in the foothills of the Los Angeles Mountains, which city is famous for its Gothic cathedral? Emma?
Number 1, please.
Number 1. Which Berlin-born golfer, who, like his father, played in the Ryder Cup team, won the Spanish Open in 3 consecutive years?
Palace?
It wasn't. Ted?
Number 4, please.
Number 4. Lying on the River Onar in the foothills of the Los Angeles Mountains, which city is famous for its Gothic cathedral?
Girona?
It is Girona, believe it or not. There's one just outside Los Angeles. Deborah, you get question 1. Which Berlin-born golfer, who, like his father, played in the Ryder Cup team, won the Spanish Open in 3 consecutive years?
It's not Lang.
It isn't. It was Peter Alice, would you believe? We tried to throw you because he was actually born in Berlin. Never mind. We've had a quiz wheel. Let's have a puzzle wheel. Rules are the same, only you get 5 seconds thinking time. They're cryptic, they're clever, they're downright difficult. We're going to try and fox you if we can. Ted, pick the first clue.
4, please.
4. It's common on a golf course.
Hole.
They are, but that's not the answer we want. Deborah.
Number three, please.
Number three. It's what you get if you burn a tree trunk. Emma.
Number four, please.
Number four. It's common on a golf course.
Rough.
Bitter rough. Common as muck. Ted.
Five, please.
Five. For a place like that in Kent, it's a bargain.
Hop.
Not what we want. Deborah.
Number one, please.
Number one, the sound but not the smell of table tennis.
Lash.
Not what we want. Emma.
Number six, please.
Number six, it gets puffed out going from bar to bar.
Wind?
Yes. As in isobars. Ted.
Two, please.
Two. It can be tricky because he really fancies himself. Deborah.
Number two, please.
Number two, it can be tricky because he really fancies himself.
Poser.
Thank you. Emma.
Number one, please.
Number one, the sound but not the smell of table tennis.
Ping.
Ping. Not the pong. Ted.
Five, please.
Five. For a place like that in Kent, it's a bargain.
Deal.
Yes, you spotted it eventually. Deborah, here's clue three. It's what you get if you burn a tree trunk.
Ash.
You certainly do. Ash and the type of a tree. OK, we've had a quiz wheel, we've had a puzzle wheel. Let's have a look at the scores. Ted's on 30 points and neck and neck. Emma and Deborah on 40 points. Well played. OK, time to play a wheel with a different spin. We're going to play a word wheel. And as everybody knows who's watched this show, one single letter can make all the difference between winning and losing at the end of the game. Emma, it's you to start. I'm going to ask you to say and spell each word that you see. Please make sure they've got at least three letters in them. Avoid proper nouns and abbreviations, but you've got 30 seconds as soon as the wheel turns.
Power, P-O-W-E-R. Record, R-E-C-O-R-D. Recorder, R-E-C-O-R-D-E-R. Range, R-A-N-G-E. Adamant, A-D-A-M-A-N-T. Pat, P-A-T, P-A-T-E. Temp, T-E-M-P. Word, W-E-R. Cord, C-O-R-D. Rang, R-A-N-G.
Emma, you were adamant about the word adamant. You spelt it perfectly correctly, it just wasn't on the wheel. But the 10 others you gave us were, so you got 10 words, 47 letters, 47 points. Well played. OK, time to hitch a ride on another general knowledge juggernaut. This time it's a quiz wheel. Remember, these are general knowledge questions. I'm going to ask Deborah to pick the first question.
Number three, please.
Number three. Which American writer achieved success with his first novel, Willy War, inspired by his wartime service in the Aleutians?
Conrad?
It wasn't. Emma?
Number three, please.
Number three. Which American writer achieved success with his first novel, Willy War, inspired by his wartime service in the Aleutians?
Kubrick?
It wasn't Kubrick. Ted?
Four, please.
Four. Which actor played Hans Gruber, the head of an international group of terrorists, in the 1988 film Die Hard?
Rickman.
It was Alan Rickman. You get 10 points here. Deborah.
I'll try number three again, please.
Number three. Which American writer achieved success with his first novel, Willy War, inspired by his wartime service in the Aleutians?
Is it Vidal?
It was Gore Vidal. Well done. Emma.
Number six, please.
Number six. Who replaced Anthony Mann as director of the screen epic Spartacus?
Kubrick.
It was. How many directors are on the wheel? Ted?
Two, please.
Two. Which American astronaut was the third man to walk on the moon? Deborah.
Question five, please.
Five. Which Scottish king invaded England in 1138 in support of Queen Matilda? Emma.
Number two, please.
Number two. Which American astronaut was the third man to walk on the moon?
Aldrin.
It wasn't. Ted?
One, please.
One. Occasional singer with the Velvet Underground, which female artist died in 1988 after falling off a bicycle on holiday in Ibiza?
Mantini.
It wasn't. Deborah?
Question two, please.
Question two. Which American astronaut was the third man to walk on the moon?
Conrad?
It was. Pete to his mates. Emma.
Number five, please.
Number five. Which Scottish king invaded England in 1138 in support of Queen Matilda?
David.
It was. Well worth guessing. 10 points. Ted, you're left with question one. Occasional singer with the Velvet Underground, which female artist died in 1988 after falling off a bicycle on holiday in Ibiza?
Davis?
It wasn't. Deborah, I'll ask it one more time for you. Occasional singer with the Velvet Underground, which female artist died in 1988 after falling off a bicycle on holiday in Ibiza?
Nico?
It is Nico. Don't shake your head. You've got it right, so we'll worry about that. OK, Ted, it's your turn for a word wheel. I'll remind you of what you have to do. Please say and spell each word that you see. Please make sure they've got at least three letters in them. Make sure you don't have any proper nouns or abbreviations, but you've got 30 seconds. They start as soon as you see the wheel turning.
Race, R-A-C-E, tone, T-O-N-E, tones, T-O-N-E-S, state, S-T-A-T-E, eight, A-T-E, ten, T-E-N-D, rap, R-A-P, point, P-O-I-N-T, ointment, O-I-N-T-M-E-N-T, terrace, T-E-R-R-A-C-E, ace, A-C-E, ton, T-O-N, nest, N-E-S-T, tat, T-A-T, ten, T-E-N, end, E-N-D,
Ted, you said a few times, but you didn't spell it. But you did spell 16 words, 67 letters, 67 points. Well played. OK, time for more loopy linguistics with the puzzle wheel. Remember, these are crossword puzzle clues. We're deliberately setting out to trick you. I'm going to ask Emma to pick the first one.
Number six, please.
Number six. Watch it, you're putting me off.
Object?
Nope. Ted?
Three, please.
Three. Everything, right or wrong, that or this, round and there.
Tally?
Nope. Deborah?
Number one, please.
Number one. It's connected, but it's a very flimsy link.
Tenuous?
Yes. 10 points. Emma?
Number six, please.
Number six. Watch it, you're putting me off.
Number one. Fob.
Yes. Well done. Ted?
Three, please.
Three. Everything, right or wrong, that or this, round and there.
All.
Thank you very much. All right or wrong, all that, all this, etc. Deborah.
Number four, please.
Clue four. It's when you put them down when they're at the bottom.
Relegate.
Yes, right on the buzzer. We'll give you that. 10 points. Emma.
Number two, please.
Number two. This gets a reaction. Whether it's desire or disapproval.
Object.
Yes, object of desire. You object, perfectly acceptable. Five for you, Ted. Yeah. This man keeps tabs on the score.
Tally.
Tally man. Okay, Deborah, it's your turn for a word wheel. Remember what you have to do. Say and spell each word that you see. Make sure they've got three letters in them at least. Avoid proper nouns and abbreviations. But your 30 seconds will start as soon as the wheel starts to turn.
Rim, R-A-M, modest, M-O-D-E-S-T, destiny, D-E-S-T-I-N-Y, tiny, T-I-N-Y, phone, P-H-O-N-E, net, N-E-T, tick, T-I-C, ice, I-C, box, B-O-X, enact, E-N-A-C-T, act, A-C-T, trim, T-R-I-M, modes, M-O-D-E-S, mode, M-O-D-E, modest, M-O-D-E-S-T. Hone, H-O-N-E, tice, T-I-C-E. Zen, X-E-N.
Deborah, you gave us a nice little word, tice, T-I-C-E, which means to entice. Pretty little word. But that was amongst 16 words that had 66 letters, so you get 66 points. Well played. OK, everybody's had a word wheel. Let's look at the scores. Emma's on 127 points, Ted's on 127 points, and Deborah's on 156, so Deborah's in the lead. Have a rest, because once again it's time for you at home to play the game. Another chance to win a 14-inch portable colour television set. In the last show, I asked the question, which British rugby union player captained England to victory in the Five Nations Championship and the Triple Crown in 1996? And the answer is Will Carling. Today, the question is, called plumbum in Latin, what metal was used by the Romans to make water pipes? called plumbum. In Latin, what metal was used by the Romans to make water pipes? Now, if you think you've spotted the answer, call us on 0891 11 4400, 0891 11 4400. The winner will be selected random from all the correct entries. The lines are open till midnight tonight, and the call should last under a minute and be charged at the premium rate, so good luck. OK, back to the game. Let me remind everybody of what we're playing for here. You're playing for a place in the semi-finals. Now, more than that, the two runners-up who have the highest scores amongst our quarterfinals will also qualify for the semi-finals. So getting the best score you can is everything. Let's look at the scores. There's no more than three right answers between you. I'll call up a quiz wheel. Fingers on the buzzers. Here's the first general knowledge question. Which best-selling poet began her showbiz career as a Butlin's redcoat? Emma.
Ayres.
It was Pam Ayres. Here's question two. Native to Australia, what is the common name given to the small marsupial? Ted.
Gerbil.
It isn't gerbil. You lose 10 points. Here's question three. Which Broadway singer-songwriter composed the hit song from The Wizard of Oz, Somewhere Over the Rainbow? Deborah.
Kay.
It wasn't Kay. You lose 10 points. Here's question four. What is the name given to any greenhouse with a double-sloped or A-shaped roof? Question five. Which popular pet native to Africa and Asia is a known carrier of the bubonic plague? Deborah.
Gerbil.
It is gerbil. 10 points. Here's question six. Originating in Turkey, which variety of rabbit has red eyes and yields fine white wool? Emma.
Angora.
It is angora, used in the manufacture of clothing. Back to question two. Native to Australia, what is the common name given to the small marsupial characterised by its large, narrow ears and bushy tail? Here's question three again. Which Broadway singer-songwriter composed the hit song from The Wizard of Oz, Somewhere Over the Rainbow? Question four. What is the name given to any greenhouse with a double-sloped or A-shaped roof? There's two again. Native to Australia, what is the common name given to the small marsupial characterised by its large, narrow ears and bushy tail? It's a bilby. Here's question three. Which Broadway singer-songwriter composed the hit song from The Wizard of Oz, Somewhere Over the Rainbow? Deborah.
Earl.
It wasn't. You lose 10 points. And you lose the lead, and the answer was Arlen. Harold Arlen. Let's go to question four. What is the name given to any... Ted.
Span.
It is Span. You get 10 points. Well played. Let's have a look at the scores. Ted's on 127, Deborah's on 146, Emma's just in the lead on 147. Let's have a puzzle wheel. Remember, these are crossword puzzle clues. Cryptic, clever, downright difficult. We're going to trick you if we can. Here's the first one. This really is Middle America. Everybody went. Emma got it.
Central.
Is the right answer. You get 10 points. Here's clue two. It's how you can take your bricks and mortar with you. Here's clue three. Those two look dead alike. Ted.
Dice.
Wrong answer. You lose 10 points. Here's clue four. The price of staying in a top hotel. Oh, everybody went dead, got it?
Grand.
Yes. 10 points. Here's clue five. It's how you put seeds to bed. Emma.
So?
You do. 10 points. Here's clue six. That's just in case we forget. Back to clue two. It's how you can take your bricks... Deborah.
Hod.
Hod is the right answer. 10 points. Here's clue three. Those two look dead alike. Question six. That's just in case we forget. Deborah.
Lest.
Lest is the right answer. 10 points. Fingers on the buzzers. Here's clue three again. Those two look dead alike. Emma.
Ringers.
Certainly do. 10 points. Let's look at the scores. Ted's on 127, Deborah's on 166, Emma's still in the lead on 177. Could we have a quiz wheel, please? Here's the first general knowledge question. Fingers on the buzzers. Used in the home and as an industrial filter, what is the name given to the fibrous skeleton of the fruit of the tropical dishcloth gourd? Deborah.
Loofah.
It is loofah. Its proper name's even more ridiculous. Here's question two. Star of Merry Christmas, Mr. Lawrence, which British rock performer? Deborah.
Bowie.
Correct, 10 points. You take the lead. Home to the Oracle of Apollo. Deborah.
Delphi.
Delphi's the right answer, another 10 points. Here's question four. Cats the Musical by Andrew Lloyd Webber is based on the works of which Nobel? Deborah.
Eliot.
It was T.S. Eliot, Nobel Prize-winning poet. Here's question five. Voiced by Phil Harris in the film of The Jungle Book. Emma.
Baloo.
It was Baloo. Exactly. What is the name of the bear that befriends the wolf boy Mowgli? Here's question six. Born in Germany, which English composer?
Handel.
Ted? Handel, correct. Let's look at the scores. Ted's on 137, Emma's on 187, our new leader's Deborah on 206. Can we have a puzzle wheel, please? Here's the first crossword puzzle clue, fingers on the buzzers. A snifter that'll stop you getting the sniffles. Emma.
Dram.
Is the right answer, 10 points. Here's clue two. It gets pulled open and left to hang about. Ted.
Drapes.
It's the wrong answer, so you lose 10 points. Here's clue three. In front, even if it's by a neck. Deborah.
Ahead.
Is the right answer, 10 points. Here's clue four. Without him, you wouldn't be here. Emma.
Father.
Is the right answer, 10 points. Here's clue five. It's how they raid your memory. Deborah.
Not ramify.
Is not ramify. You're right, you lose 10 points. Here's clue six. He hasn't got blue blood, but he's from good stock. Well, that's the end of the game. I can't even take your answer. Let's look at the scores. Ted's on 127 points. Deborah's on 206 points. By 1 point, Emma is our winner today on 207. Well played. Sadly, Ted, we have to say goodbye to you. I've hoped you enjoyed playing three times. It's been great having you. Deborah, you might be pleased to know, you're our highest scoring runner-up at the minute. So you have an anxious few days to find out whether you get through to the semis. But Emma, you're through to the semis. But who will she be playing? Find out in the next quarterfinal right here on Incognito. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.
Next on BBC One, more quizzing in Wipeout.
Down towards the sleep is a lot worse than that, with thunder in the skies. The Aegean itself, 10 to 20 millimetres. Ishmir, particularly wet at 60. Of course, there'll be rather more rain there as it slowly dies out, moving towards Turkey. The northern plain doesn't change very much throughout Wednesday. For Thursday, again, the pattern's not a lot different. The subtle change is yet more rain is pointed down towards Iberia. A lot of it may be showery by the end of the day. And more rain will be running in towards Italy, up in towards the Balkans, with a lot more snow for the Alps and the northern Balkans in particular. As for this country, well, I'm afraid we're still cold and cloudy. As you can see, the outbreaks of light snow, particularly in England and Wales, the best chance of sunshine, northern Scotland, but also around the Bay of Liverpool and crossing towards the Wash. A cold day, a cold night to come, and a little great improvement until maybe by the end of the weekend, then back to normal.
The boys are back, and they're branching out.
The yard's yours. You can make of it what you can.
3,000. We're going to do this job, we're going to do it proper.
I've been thinking. A couple of new costumes.
Marie, you're pregnant.
You can't just bar folk from jobs because they're up the dove. It's illegal.
Not when the strippers, it's not.
I do not want help in across the road.
I'm a big lad now. The only way to get on is by yourself.
The award-winning Commoner's Muck returns tonight, 9:30 on BBC One.
In Search of the Missing Words, once again, now on BBC One, it's the first semi-final of Incognito.
Hello, welcome to Incognito. This is the first of our semi-finals. Over the next two shows, six people will be battling out for a place in the final and a chance of a trip around the world. So would you please welcome again Margaret Burke from Liverpool, Roger Hemming from Wellington in Somerset, and Deborah Lewis from Newcastle. Margaret.
Yes.
You showed us all how to play a word, Will. 83 letters, 83 points, fantastic play. You feeling confident today?
I think that was a fluke, but I'll try.
I'm sure you do well. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Roger, you got the wedding waistcoat on again?
Indeed.
I remember from the first time we met, you also have a penchant for not wearing socks.
Only to work.
Only to work. You got none on now?
None today.
Anything else you're not wearing you want to mention?
No, I've got full kit today.
Full kit today. Glad to hear it. Roger, it's good to see you. Deborah.
Hi.
Boy, what a quarterfinal you played. You missed winning by 1 point, but you really went for it on the buzzer. You up for that today?
I don't think I was thinking tactically.
Well, it got you here today, and it's all square. Nobody's got any points yet, so we're all equal. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, our contestants. We're going to play a quiz wheel first, as everybody knows, so I'll call one up. And I'll remind you of what we have to do. 6 general knowledge questions. You get to pick which question you want me to ask. When I ask the question, the wheel starts to turn. Doesn't stop until you give me an answer or you run out of 3 seconds thinking time. Right answers win you 10 points. Wrong answers don't matter. The wheel's only finished when I get 6 right answers or I've asked each question 3 times. We remember this, don't we? Margaret, I'll ask you to pick the first question.
Number 5, please.
Number 5. Produced by Howard Hawks, which classic 1951 science fiction film features Arctic scientists who discover an alien life form frozen in the ice cap? Roger.
Number 3, please.
Number 3. Which Central American ruler was arrested in 1989 by the US Army and convicted for 40 years of drug trafficking?
Noriega.
It was Manuel Noriega. Deborah.
Number 1, please.
Number 1. Composed mainly of tartrates and yeasts, what is the name given to those deposits that settle in wine casks during fermentation? Margaret.
Number 1, please.
Number 1. Composed mainly of tartrates and yeasts, what is the name given to those deposits that settle in wine casks during fermentation?
Lees.
Lees is the right answer. You get 10 points. Roger.
Number 6, please.
Number 6. The son of Lancelot and Elaine, which of the knights of the Round Table finds the Holy Grail? Deborah.
Number 6, please.
Number 6. The son of Lancelot and Elaine, which of the knights of the Round Table finds the Holy Grail?
Galahad.
It certainly is. Margaret.
Number 4, please.
Number 4. Voted mayor of Palm Springs, California in 1988, who had a single in 1965 singing I Got You, Babe?
Bono.
It was Sonny Bono. Roger.
2, please.
Number 2. Who played aviator Charles Lindbergh in the 1957 biopic The Spirit of St. Louis?
Stewart.
It was James Stewart. 10 points. Deborah, 5 for you. Produced by Howard Hawks, which classic 1951 science fiction film features Arctic scientists who discover an alien life form frozen in the ice cap?
Thing?
It is The Thing. You looked as if you were guessing. It was well worth guessing. OK, we've had a quiz wheel. Let's have a puzzle wheel. Remember, these are crossword puzzle clues. Cryptic, clever, downright difficult. We're going to try and trick you. Roger, pick the first clue.
5, please.
Number 5. It's taken for granted when you say it.
Nope.
Deborah.
Number 3, please.
Number 3. It's when a man can be your sister. Margaret.
Number 1, please.
Number 1. You don't seem very happy about this. It gets given and received, but it can be anonymous.
Donation.
Thank you. Roger.
2, please.
2. He's a cat fit for a king.
Nope.
Deborah.
Number 3 again, please.
Number 3. It's when a man can be your sister.
Nurse.
Thank you. 10 points. Margaret.
2, please.
2. He's a cat fit for a king.
Leopard.
He's not what we want. Roger.
4, please.
4. It's just a lot of people with one set of rules.
Nope.
It's on the wheel. Deborah.
Number 4, please.
Number 4. It's just a lot of people with one set of rules.
Hurdle.
It's not what we want. Margaret.
Number 2 again, please.
Number 2. He's a cat fit for a king.
Arthur.
Thank you very much. Roger.
Number 4, please.
Number 4. It's just a lot of people with one set of rules.
Nation.
Yes. You spotted it that time. Deborah, 5 or 6?
6, please.
6. A car that's made in China.
Panda.
Yes. Margaret, here's five for you. It's taken for granted when you say it.
Word?
Nope. Roger, I'll say it one more time for you. It's taken for granted when you say it.
Pardon.
Thank you. Deborah got it right at the last minute. OK, we've had a quiz wheel, we've had a puzzle wheel. Let's have a look at the scores. Look at this. Do you think this is a semi-final or what? Margaret's on 40, Roger's on 40, Deborah's on 40. Excellent beginning. OK, time to play a wheel with a different spin. We're going to play a word wheel. I'll remind you that one letter difference can mean the difference between winning and losing at the end of the game. I'll ask Margaret to start. I'll ask you to say and spell each word that you see. Please make sure they've got at least three letters in them. You must avoid proper nouns and abbreviations. You've got 30 seconds. Your time starts as soon as you see the wheel turn.
Dog, D-O-G, steam, S-T-E-A-M, mate, M-A-T-E. Tear, T-A-E-A-R, tear away, T-E-A-R, A-W-A-Y, away, A-W-A-Y, egg, E-double-G, eggs, E-double-G-S, eggshell, E-double-G, S-H-E-double-L, lip, L-I-P, pseudo, P-S-E-U-D-O, dogs, D-O-G-S, T, T-E-A, ear, E-A-R, I, A-Y-E, hell, H-E-double-L, lips, L-I-P-S.
Margaret, there's a lovely word on the wheel, which is yeg, Y-E-double-G, means a burglar. Never heard of one of those before. 17 words, 73 letters, 73 points. Thank you very much. OK, time for another drive around the mean semantic streets of a quiz wheel. Remember, these are general knowledge questions. I'll ask Deborah to pick the first one.
Number three, please.
Number three. Who wrote Modern Man in Search of a Soul and the semi-autobiographical Memories, Dreams, Reflections that was published after his death?
Gray.
It wasn't Gray. Margaret.
Number two, please.
Number two. Invented by G.K. Chesterton, which detective has been portrayed on film by Alec Guinness and Kenneth Moore?
Brown.
It was Father Brown. Roger.
Number four, please.
Number four. Originally a travelling grocery salesman without technical background, who invented the first successful four-stroke internal combustion engine?
Prescott.
It wasn't. Deborah.
Number five, please.
Number five. Which American inventor was involved in a famous legal battle with Alexander Graham Bell over the invention of the telephone?
Gray.
That was Gray. Well done. 10 points. Margaret.
Number one, please.
Number one. Former opposition spokesman for trade and industry and the environment, which Labour politician ran against John Smith in the 1992 leadership election?
Prescott.
It wasn't. Roger.
Four, please.
Four. Originally a travelling grocery salesman without technical background, who invented the first successful four-stroke internal combustion engine?
Browning.
It wasn't. Deborah.
Number six, please.
Number six. Which lay preacher provided the voice for Penfold in the cartoon series Danger Mouse?
Gould?
It wasn't. Margaret?
Number three, please.
Number three. Who wrote Modern Man in Search of a Soul and the semi-autobiographical Memories, Dreams, Reflections that was published after his death?
Jung?
It was Jung. Carl Jung. Excellent. Roger.
Number one, please.
Number one. Former opposition spokesman for trade and industry and the environment, which Labour politician ran against John Smith in the 1992 leadership election?
Brown.
It wasn't Brown. Deborah.
Number one, please.
Number one. Former opposition spokesman for trade and industry and the environment, which Labour politician ran against John Smith in the 1992 leadership election?
Was it Gould?
It was Brian Gould. Four or six, Margaret?
Six, please.
Six. Which lay preacher provided the voice for Penfold in the cartoon series Danger Mouse? Roger.
Four, please.
Four. Originally a travelling grocery salesman without technical background, who invented the first successful four-stroke internal combustion engine?
Scott.
It wasn't. It was a man called Nicholas August Otto. Oh. You learn something new on this show every day. Here's question six for you, Deborah. Which lay preacher provided the voice for Penfold in the cartoon series Danger Mouse?
Scott.
It was Terry Scott. Well done. Almost had to be. Roger, your chance. You know what you have to do. Mm-hmm. Please say and spell each word that you see. Make sure they've got three letters in them. Avoid proper nouns and abbreviations, but you've got 30 seconds. Your time starts as soon as you see the wheel turn.
Dare, D-A-R-E, fine, F-I-N-E. Part, P-A-R-T, particle, P-A-R-T-I-C-L-E. Cleft, C-L-E-F-T, over, O-V-E-R. Room, R-U-M-E, rumen, R-U-M-E-N. Refine, R-E-F-I-N-E. Neap, N-E-A-P. Left, L-E-F-T, leftover, L-E-F-T-O-V-E-R.
Roger, you ended on leftover, which seems appropriate. You didn't leave many words left over on the wheel. You got 11 words, 56 letters, 56 points. Very well played. OK, time for another maze of amusing mysteries with a puzzle wheel. Remember, these are crossword puzzle clues. They're tricky, but they're worth 10 points. I'll ask Margaret to pick the first one.
Number three, please.
Number three. Sonic the Hedgehog is great.
Super.
Yes. I like answers with enthusiasm. Roger.
Number five, please.
Number five. On the level, it's where you tread the boards.
Stage.
Thank you. Deborah.
Number four, please.
Number four. You can't have a sing-song without one.
Richard.
Not what we wanted. No. I'm sure Cliff would be appreciative. Margaret.
Number two, please.
Number two. Be positive and it won't go flat.
Tire.
Nope.
Number two, please.
Number two. Be positive and it won't go flat.
Charge.
Charge is what we wanted. Well spotted. Deborah.
Number one, please.
Number one. They can be slick, but not if you're on the open road.
Gear.
Nope. Margaret.
Number four, please.
Number four. You can't have a sing-song without one.
Lyric.
Lyric. 1 point. Roger.
Number one, please.
They can be slick, but not if you're on the open road.
Tire.
I'm afraid that's not the right answer. Deborah.
Number six, please.
Number six. This place has its limits, but it's full of life.
Charge.
It's not what we want. Margaret.
Number one, please.
Number one. They can be slick, but not if you're on the open road.
Tires.
Tires, plural. Sorry, Roger. See how you go on six?
Yeah.
This place has its limits, but it's full of life. Deborah, this place has its limits, but it's full of life.
Age?
City limits?
Yes.
Everybody saw it in the end. Never mind. Okay, Deborah, time to go it alone. What you have to do is say and spell each word that you see. Make sure they've got at least three letters in them. You must avoid proper nouns and abbreviations. You've got 30 seconds. Your time starts as soon as you see the wheel turn.
Sob, S-O-B, bank, B-A-N-K, banking, B-A-N-K-I-N-G, got, G-O-T, her, H-E-R, hero, H-E-R-O, ice, I-C-E, iceberg, I-C-E-B-R-E-R-G, grand, G-R-A-N-D, grand iron, G-R-A-N-D-I-O-R-N, iron, I-R-O-N, king, K-I-N-G, goth, G-O-T-H, C-E-B-E, and A-N-D.
You gave us the word grandiron, which we couldn't find, but while we were looking, we did come across the word andiron, which means the metal supports in a wood fire. But you did get 13 words, you got 54 letters, 54 points. Very well played. OK, everybody's had a word wheel. Let's look at the scores. Margaret's on 163 points, Roger's on 116, and Deborah's on 124, so Margaret's currently in the lead. Have a rest. Sit back, relax, because once again it's time for you at home to play the game. Another chance to win a 14-inch portable colour television set. In the last show, I asked the question, what type of fruit includes the varieties Russet, Scarlet Pimpernel and Laxton's Fortune? And the answer is apple. But today we're playing with a new quiz wheel, and our question is, what is the name given to an image of a distant object caused by atmospheric refraction of hot desert air? What is the name given to an image of a distant object caused by atmospheric refraction of hot desert air? Now, if you think you've spotted the answer, call us on 0891 11 4400, 0891 11 4400. The winner will be selected at random from all the correct entries. The lines are open till midnight tonight. Calls will last under a minute and be charged at the premium rate, so good luck. Back to the game. This is a semi-final. We're playing for a place in the final. You can get there two ways. Whoever wins today automatically goes through. But whoever is the highest scoring runner-up over the next two semi-finals also goes through. So there's a lot to play for. We're going to play on the buzzer, which means I'm going to ask the questions in order. You buzz in if you think you've got the right answer. The first one to buzz in, who gives me the right answer, gets 10 points. But if they give me a wrong answer or no answer, I will take 10 points away, and I have to be very strict, as you already know. I'll call up a quiz wheel. Here we have six general knowledge questions. Good luck to everybody. Fingers on the buzzers. Here's the first one. Who played the title role in the 1968 film Oliver? Roger.
Lester.
It was Mark Lester. Well played. Here's question two. In 1982, who was Sweden's largest foreign... Deborah.
ABBA.
It was ABBA. Largest foreign currency earners. Well spotted. Here's question three. Written and created by Carla Lane, what 1993 sitcom starred Michael Angelis and Sue Johnston? Here's question four. With which part of the body is the branch of medicine stomatology concerned? Question five. Which African tree said to have been plucked... Roger again.
Baobab.
Baobab is the right answer. Here's question six. In December 1992, at the Smash Hits Reader's Poll Party Awards, who was voted most fanciable male? Deborah.
Mark Owen.
It was Mark Owen. We like to mix up our clues. Here's question three. Written and created by Carla Lane, what 1993 sitcom starred Michael Angelis and Sue Johnston? Here's question four again. With which part of the body? Roger.
Mouth.
It is the mouth. 10 points. Fingers on the buzzers. Here's question three for the last time. Written, created by Carla Lane. Margaret.
Love.
Love is what we wanted. 10 points. Well done. Let's look at the scores. Deborah's on 144 points. Roger's on 146. Margaret's keeping her lead on 173. Let's have a puzzle wheel. Crossword puzzle clues. Cryptic, clever, downright difficult. Some might even amuse you. Here's the first one. You'll attract it if you stand very... Margaret.
Attention.
Attention. Stand very still. Stand at attention. Here's clue two. It's a good idea to give it to me straight. Clue three. It casts a magic light. Roger.
Lantern.
Tis. 10 points. Clue four. It's an industrial sewing machine. Deborah.
Tractor.
Yes, well done. Couldn't fool you with the spelling of sewing. Clue five. It can be heavy, so it's best to go and hire it. Margaret.
Plant.
It is. Heavy plant. Well done. Here's clue six. It's not the royal we, but it's a posh me. Deborah.
One.
Yes, of course. One would say only one. Here's clue two. It's a good idea to give it to me straight. Roger.
Neat.
Neat. I wondered how you took your whiskey. Let's have a look at the score. Wow. Deborah's on 164. Roger's just ahead on 166. Margaret's on 193. Can we have a quiz wheel, please? Here's the first general knowledge question. Fingers on the buzzers. Containing the first magnitude stars, Rigel and Betelgeuse. Margaret.
Orion.
Orion is the right answer. I would have said which constellation lies between Taurus and Canis Major. Here's question two. With eight top 10 singles to his credit, which Motown singer was shot dead by his father in 1984? Roger.
Gay.
It was Marvin Gaye. Here's question three. In 1979, who signed an agreement with Menachem Begin? Deborah.
Sadat.
It was Anwar Sadat at Camp David. Here's question four. Played by Nigel Planer, which of the young ones had a number one hit with his version? Roger.
Neil.
It was Neil, his version of the Traffic single Hole in My Shoe. Here's question five. What is the name of the humanoid android played by David Spiner in the TV series Star Trek The Next Generation? Deborah.
Oh, it's right there. It's gone.
Gone. Unfortunately, you lose 10 points. Here's question six. Which Oscar-winning actress provided the voice of Baby Maggie in the cult cartoon series The Simpsons? Back to question five. What is the name of the humanoid android? Deborah again.
Data.
Data. Lieutenant Commander Data. You got him back. Here's question six. Which Oscar-winning actress provided the voice of Baby Deborah?
Taylor.
It was Elizabeth Taylor. Well done. Let's look at the scores. Deborah's on 184. Roger's on 186. Margaret's on 203. This is getting exciting. Can we have a puzzle wheel, please? Here's the first crossword puzzle clues. Fingers on the buzzers. It's only polite to cover it with your hand. Roger.
Yawn.
Correct. 10 points. Here's clue two. Granted, she's getting better by degrees. Clue three. It's how you put on the squeeze if you can bear it. Roger.
Hug.
Hug. Well spotted. You take the lead. Here's clue four. This charts the courses. Clue five. A tank won't start if its tank's like this. Roger.
Empty.
Empty. You extend the lead. Here's clue six. They say it's more, but it can't be. Deborah.
No.
It's not what we want. You lose 10 points. Back to two. Granted, she's getting... Deborah.
Student.
Well done. 10 points back. Here's clue four. This charts the courses. Margaret.
Oh, menu.
We'll just give you that. 10 points. Here's clue six again. They say it's more... Roger.
Less.
Is right. They say it's more or less, but it can't be, can it? Let's have a look at the scores. Deborah's on 184, Margaret's on 213, Roger's in the lead on 226. Can we have a quiz wheel, please? Here's the first general knowledge question. In May 1990, who won an overwhelming victory in the Romanian presidential elections? Deborah.
Iliescu.
It was Iliescu. You get 10 points. Here's question two. Formerly known as Basuto Land, which country became... Everybody went. Roger got it.
Lesotho.
Lesotho is the right answer. Became independent under the constitutional monarch Moshoeshoe II. Here's question three. In 1817, Bernardo O'Higgins became the first president of which country? Deborah.
Chile.
It was Chile. 10 points. Here's question four. On March the 26th, 1989, which Arsenal player famously scored in the last minute of the last game of the season to win the league? Deborah.
Thomas.
It was Michael Thomas, Liga Championship. Question five. An honorary life member of the FA who was the first British footballer? Margaret.
Wright.
It was Billy Wright to win 100 caps. Here's question six. Who took over from Kate Jackson in TV's Charlie's Angels? One more time. Who took over from Kate Jackson in TV's Charlie's Angels? The last time. Who took over from Kate Jackson in TV's Charlie's Angels? Well, the answer was Bach, but let's have a look at the scores. Wow. Deborah's on 214 points, Margaret's on 223 points, but today's winner is Roger on 236. Fantastic play. What an amazing game. They are fantastic scores. Deborah, sadly, we have to say goodbye to you, but we're going to send you away with a magnum of champagne to drown your sorrows with. Margaret, you're going to have to wait to the next semi-final to find out if you're our highest scoring runner-up. So we'll give you a magnum of champagne to keep it going.
Thank you. Thanks.
Roger, you're through. You're in the final. Congratulations. Who will Roger play? Who will be the highest scoring runner-up? Find out on the next semi-final here on Incognito. Come and see it. Bye-bye.
They took away his life.
Ivanhoe!
What is that?
They took away his love.
I must give myself to that ox whenever he wants me.
But they couldn't take away his pride.
There are tales told against me. I will not rest nor come back to this house till I have faced the man who has destroyed my honor.
Are you afraid of him?
I stand square with any man on earth.
A story of courage and passion in a brutal world. Ivanhoe begins Sunday at 9:20 on BBC One.
More dodgy definitions now on BBC One, and the man in charge, as usual, Bob Holness.